Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away?
Clears, I'm gonna catch a sunfish with filet and make a sunfish sandwich. Sunfish sandwich with hot sauce.
Shut down, give up some.
I'd say the strangest occurrence was the shower birch.
Shower birch?
Yeah.
What happened?
Shower filled up with water.
On the RV.
Ruined all the scribble work, so everybody that's wearing one of those small black scribble shirts right now, they've been washed and dried.
Smart ass.
They're not new.
Motherfuckers. I'll tell you. Tour veterans. Mr. Dibbs. Hey, let's put all this shit in the shower. Dibs like, hey, it doesn't matter as long as it's not gonna be. Puts them in the fucking shower. Cats are sleeping 20 hours in a row. They wake up. Shower been on 2-3 hours. All the scribble shirts is fucked up. Now, where's Prince merch? Not in the shower.
Where was my merch?
Where's Dibs shirt?
In a second box up.
Is it really gonna happen?
No, because of the people on the tour, the ones running it have never toured other than Tony. I mean, I wouldn't have had to get, you know, I wouldn't be wearing my wife's black glasses right now if y'all had toured.
I figured it'd be dope, especially if at least the people who actually throw it were involved, not just like each city kind of tries to do their own version of it.
Because you guys suck.
It actually changed every night depending on what they did. I liked when he did Haunt and Lawrence. He got the shit beat out of himself.
Everybody rush me!
Doing Haunt and jumping in the crowd and having them flip out, that's probably one of my favorite parts. It used to be when him and I would kind of battle each other and see if we could go kind of like, you know, rhythmically, see if we could go, you know, whatever, toe to toe with each other.
When him and DQ would go back and forth, kind of battle.
I rock up with a pattern, shun my delivery is precise and nice as ADM screams twice. From the words and I'm moving tonight. Just slice a knife through the air to the crowd, making sure we just get down. And I can't even care when you just want to stare into my plate. I'll be to the words, they are complete. And ADM making sure sweet, unique with the beat that I find. ADM breaking down your mind to a point with another motherfucker just want to hit my ammo and hit where it want. I'm gonna begin my words on the break right there. But with the pattern, ADM just see we can react. Just want. down to relax. And here's the facts, in the end we'll bring this motherfucker back. Your attention that I need, this is what I got, so I'm guessing gonna feed all of your brains like oxygen to the blue blood to your vein. We just stop in the middle of the beat of your heart. Any of us making sure I just start right at the beginning, and yes, I'm sitting. Any of us making sure that I'm winning. You in the pattern that I find, I can bring it down one more time. One more time for the rhyme I'm screaming. Any of us making sure that I just dream, and we can make up the own pattern when we break it down for y'all in Lawrence, Kansas. I can feel that this is the beat just bouncing off the brainwave, feeling static. My proportion, it's distortion static. We can hold it, I can break it down if y'all fold it. 80, I'm killing it, making sure that I'm just delivering the pattern, making sure that I'm just sailing it. My fate on the stage tonight, we can do technical tricks. It doesn't matter if my words aren't thick. If I can't freestyle, I'll liquor show that my history as an MC is not defined by the special. The poetry is not defined, but the people just holding the guns. It matters the way Uzi is a ton. Uzi is a ton, so I'm just waiting for the beat to come right back just to me. I'm screaming for a little bit of more. We want to just hold your head and feel the rhythm. Just bring your body down. Just this is a party. We can hold you with your head. Screaming it out, you know what I mean? So, motherfucker, show you where I'm at. Kill these motherfuckers when they stepping on the mic like this. Oh, baby, like this. We be in the club, acting kinda good, making motherfuckers realize that we don't need to do that shit. Like,
louder that we get, see, faster that we go. Cool, louder that you get, the faster that we go. Louder that you get, the faster that we go. Louder that you get, and see, the faster that we go. See, pattern my delivery, you're what I really show. Got the crowd right eating at the vomit on the head, and making sure that when we demonstrate, we move with the man. The mic, I'm with the ladder, with the cable, my delivery, you're strong, I'm with the look of the chivalry is worth. Any game is making sure that just turns to your brain, and making sure that I'm in the world. Work doesn't matter how fast I'm around, and it breaks, so everyone down with the round. Rhyme with the pattern, and make sure that my delivery is coming over like this, huh? Yeah, I'm in Lawrence, Kansas now. You're now watching the beat that I gotta make sure that you might just want to feel it when I hear some motherfucking noise right now.
So, you know, my favorite part of the glue set was the glue set.
Billy Jean, when he does that shit, that's dope. He made this a night to remember, you know, and then has the crowd sing it. I like that part. That's my favorite part of the set.
Billy Jean. I think everybody would agree that Billy Jean was the...
Can we have some fun real quick? He ain't in jail yet. Her face got all frowned up like this Michael Jackson. He ain't in jail yet. We can still move around. What? I met this chick up in the scribble. B-girls turn me on, the vibe of the song banging in my ear, I can barely hear. This is very clear, come here. She came responding with Elaine as a name. White dame with a nice frame. Shit, I'm feeling her life pain. She said she made the drive from Lorraine just to see my show cause I had a lot of fame. I said, word, that's good to hear. Don't tell me your man left you alone in here, cause if he did, that's kinda foul. Guys like me are always on the prowl. She cracked a smile, grabbed my butt, said, what makes you think that's not what I really want? Shit, girl, I got the keys to the van and an hour to spare if you ain't playing. Forget hip-hop, forget about shit, man. If y'all feeling this shit, then raise your hands. Fuck hip-hop, y'all. It's a party now. Raise your hands. Let's make this a night to remember. We only live once, no need to fuck. And if you feel what I'm talking about, then say hell yeah. Let's make this a night to remember. We only live once, no need to fuck. And if you feel what I'm talking about, then say that's right. Sing along.
Evil always told me, careful what you do. Go around breaking young girls. Blah 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 blah.
Billie Jean is my love.
Sing along. She's just a girl.
You sound beautiful. Keep it going.
But the chance.
Not my son, yeah.
He did boombox because on God Loves Ugly, boombox was just a acetate instrumental without the Nas hook. And it's just when I was like rugged hip hop song. I can't believe that's actually coming out of my mouth.
And if you ever owned a boombox in your life, the single's called Boombox. What? I got a Panasonic with a set of 15s. Black with the silver grill shining, looking clean. Glove on my right hand, faces on mean. I keep it by my side like Radio Raheem Ghetto Blasting. What? You know the sound. Everywhere I go, I get asked to turn it down. I'll tell you hell no to your face. I ain't a coward. And if you keep tripping, I'ma turn it up louder. I don't give a damn about your quiet or your peace. The only time I turn it down is when I see police. The last thing I need, biggest sweated by the beast. Trying to throw me in a hole and take away my beats. Ain't hear nothing but the music I'm slipping. So fuck hip hop, I'm easy listening. What? Ain't nothing but the music I'm tripping. So fuck hip hop. You thought it was good shots.
The groove knows titties.
The groove is still a respectful dude. Recognize that. You know what I'm saying?
The way titties bulge out of a shirt. It's so different, you know what I mean, compared to when it's in a brooch.
And the padage is like an extra umph. And the groove can tell an extra umph from a regular titty that's pulling, you know, bulging out of a shirt. You know what I'm saying?
Daddy doesn't have to hop that thing. He'll open his fucking mouth. When I get up there. The hate breed part used to be my favorite part of his set. Before like I got up there, honestly, like I liked that a lot because I felt like that brought out something in him where he went past the DJ and became like a performer.
What's up? No! No! Now is the time for me to rise to my feet. Wipe your sweat from my face. Wipe your tears from my eyes. I will be.
Was like vocal, like you could see all like that energy that sort of is has been collected up into him just bursting out. I saw him doing it on the Warped Tour. It was like the part where he was just kind of doing his thing, going through the motions of being atmosphere as DJ. But then when it was his turn, it was like the dude got fucking knocked down and he fucking metaphysics.
I like when everybody has the confused look, like how's it go from Cheers to House of Pain to Snoop Dogg to AC/DC. I get off on the like, I don't understand how you play all that one fit. Up to the Hatebreed part is all hip hop shit. And so there's a certain element of the crowd that's there that the last 10 minutes before Hatebreed are really fucking excited. Mm-hmm. Like those are the kids that would potentially boo you during the first 20. Last 10, they're just fucking. Shit ass awesome. Then they get up front and then they get the shit kicked out of them during Hatebreed.
I will be able to hear.
It was like kicking myself in the balls every night.
If there's one way for this tour to lose money and look bad, it is flying some of these fucking Chauncey ass, Buster ass, Mark ass, Kirk, dick sucking, ball licking.
I think it's easy for someone who ain't talented to go for theirs.
My favorite part was being up there with Dibs and him giving up every night after maybe a round and a half.
I'd rather change tires on the RV than judge the MC battle.
Props out to Iron Solomon.
And I'ma leave this dude spoiled. He's a rabbi, but I'ma cut this dickhead off like I'm the Moyle. Solomon in the spot, billing it. When y'all know I'm killing it, willing it.
take you outside into the ground now. Well, I know I'm drilling it, cause come on, man, you can't forget the flow from head to toe. Yo, bitch, the shit from tip to toe. She looks like the girl that I would get to go. I'm the shit for show. Give a pound to this guy. I spit fly. I got the ill car hearts. Got the ill car hearts, but your breast smells like a fucking aardvark. And I'm a car shark. So deal me an ace, cause I spit real in the place. And I might squeal in your face like yo, bitch does. Homie, do we need to go do a round two? Do we need to see another time where I pound you? You are so fucking whack, dude, you don't have loot, so you had to buy your grandfather's damn tracksuit. And on this mic, I've been a hog. I'm about to eat a fucking cheeseburger in your synagogue. So I'll be just embalming you. Whoever heard of a rabbi with no yarmulke? This guy's so flavorless. I'll come to you and rip off your payuses. Cause I spit real, he's a bitch real. Come on, I'll battle you in Israel. Don't care how the kid feels, we can do this. Have a battle to see which one is more Jewish. And you shouldn't be rocking his tea, because come on, it's obvious it's me, Baruch Hashem.
Yeah, it goes, yo, 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 yo. Ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, I just opened a store and it's called Rapping Toys. Yeah, meet my product line, please meet them. Then say goodbye, cause I will quickly beat them. And after that, we will clash. Am I battling Iron Solomon or Radar from MASH? Oh, that's what I wonder, I flex men. Give it up to Hugh Jackman from X-Men. Yes, you got claws, I'm too raw like the WWF. Me, you haven't saw, so please, homie, you'll need a priest. When Ryan release, bitch, I'm fatter than Della Reese. So please cease, they don't know who that is. When I come through like this and I handle my biz. So let me ask you something, why you combing your stash? Why you get annoying like a motherfucking diaper rash?
Yeah! Okay, he sprayed hard. He might have called me Radar, but the shit that he spit, it send off my gaydar. And the thing is that if I'm Hugh Jackman, they'd rather see Hugh Jackman than watch you rapping. Cause dude, you sound like a country bumpkin. And his shirt looks like a fucking shrunken pumpkin. He can't spit it with me. They said come off the head presence. His hair took it literally. You going for that Mr. Dibs? Look, but he got blistered lips. And I write with the pen till I'm dead. He looks like Mr. Dibs if he glued the hair from his chin to his head. Yeah. Alright, homie, let me just get the lyricist to jizz and shit. I'm about to kick this shit and make this motherfucker scissor snip. Come on, dog, you fake as a bitch. I'll make your mom suck my dick while I'm taking a shit. And I won't let her stop till I nut in her hair strands. Make her stand up and wipe my ass with her bare hands. Turn around and wipe this shit on your chin. Now you really know what it's like to have a shit-eating grin. You come and test me, you really can't catch me. I'm sorry, stop shaking, you have epilepsy. I'm a true villain in my own new village. You look like a crackhead version of Bruce Willis. With your eyes popping out, you're not rocking out. Nah, I'm not stopping now, let me keep going. He tries to rap hollow. You look like an aging retired Gap model.
No can do.
Irrelevant, there's bullshit on the side of the stage and this fat fuck is selling it. I come and break it down by the melanin. You wanna say I'm skinny, look like a skeleton. My dick's big and the chick got the measurements. I came to represent like LA's Mexicans. We in the place now, making you lay down. Like that, I got half of the crowd, no rapping allowed. They come in the place, hey, let me hand you a fucking napkin. You got cum on your face with nothing to say. Your ideas and thoughts are whack, they're running away. Just jumping with Jay, they come.
And you about to get caught in a whirlwind. This is the celibate dude on Girlfriends. Nigga, I hurt him. You wanna be, nigga, follow me around the corner and don't spit it out, little nigga, swallow me. You like kids in your throat, you talking about what you spitting is dope, you're written is nope. Ain't nobody feeling it in the crowd, you might as well call me a king, nigga. I'm holding it down, I'm gravity, I'm holding it down, owning the town, I'm blowing this clown. This nigga ain't holding it nothing.
Hey, you need to stop now, playing it safe. You are holding it down now, you're a paperweight. Make them come back at a later date. That's a fat joke. While he got his ass open, your cash broke. No wallet, hang the mic. Forgot about it when I rock it. You wanna see as fast as a fiber optic? I'll pick him. Have a mosh pit, and this is not even a rock show. Where's your mama at? I'm about to show her where my cock go. Yeah, you know you could predict shit. It's so simple. My freestyle, nah, don't even give me a handshake. I'll spill your blood all over the damn place. MCs like you get served in my landscape. I'm kind of about it.
That dude, the thesaurus, I think, in San Francisco was really dope.
It's black and white. You shouldn't grab the mic, cause I'ma slap this guy till my appetite is satisfied. Listen, Bo, I'm packing the sickest flow. You can hop around stage like a rabbit that's pigeon-toed, but it doesn't matter, it's something drastic. Hold me back or Buck Elastic's gonna get his fucking ass kicked. Oh god, I guess you're riding the vert ramp, it's the first champ. I guess that I'm leaving your pants damp. Oh god, I guess your panties wet. I'll never give this man respect, I should've freestyled a manifest.
I spit it, then I rip again. I'm twice as sick as him. When you jump around, I saw your man tits jiggling, and I almost caught a boner. But Bo Rat's been living in 5 months in Barcelona, sap a Corona. Hey yo, I'm socking him with lead gloves. Look at my arm, it's got more hair than his fucking head does. Ouchie, yo, I'm calling it off. You're 23 and balding, and your flows are straight up appalling. I know a guy, but my flow is fly. I'm showing why I'm the dopest on the mic. There's no denying that. I kick a tighter rap, and you spit whack freestyles on stage and in the fucking cypher. You're right.
My homie Isaiah. Isaiah is half native, and there's a point where you cross a certain, even though it's a battle, there's a point where you cross a certain line. You know, like maybe saying, you know, you're a pair of glasses. I don't know.
Take the fuck away from the reservation. This is Phoenix. Homie, I need to break it to you on the band. I have the blood to win. My grandpa stole your land. Open the casino, cause you ain't kicking me, homie, no bueno. Was that a little me? I'm sorry, hold on, you ain't making the soggy chart. I'll rip your face off and wear it for a mask. What are y'all showing you? You fucking rap's really bad. Was that hating in that coop? I didn't mean it. Sorry, dog, to your last name was gay, suck my penis. I say it twice, cause I told you to rap a version of a transvestite.
Are you real? Talk about casinos, you got my casinos, play my jackpot and pay my bills. So what you want to do? I'm gonna get you literally in front too. I gotta tell you, oh well, talk about a reservation. The only reservation I got was in the bomb and that's at a hotel.
I thought we know, but I don't think that you can see me. Why don't you go on a vision quest and eat some peyote in a teepee? I had to come with you real shit and keep it raw. I'm the realest crappy that you ever fucking saw. I'm sorry, baby, I don't want to be naked. It's not that I hate this, dog, I keep it placing. You ain't complacent when you lay it down, no God. Did you pray it to the sun, but that's not really the God. Homie, I pray to Jesus Christ because I'm nice. And I'ma tell you once I told you a transvestite thrice. It's just I mean it when I come to the city of Phoenix. And when I'm coming, I'ma use your woman to clean out the place inside my penis. Sorry if I just started doing that. Cause you never know something I'm happy that you cannot be done with.
He crossed the line with the native shit, and Isaiah wasn't having it. And I guess Isaiah and homie already knew each other, and some words were exchanged, and Isaiah's not the guy to exchange words with unless you're gonna knuckle up. And he belted him in the mouth, and then hopped off the stage and beat his ass.
I love it. Like, first of all, I don't have to drive a single fucking mile, which makes me happy, because I've gotten more sleep on this tour than I have, like, I think in the last 2.5 years of my life. It's just, it compares because I feel like we played bigger venues, and like I said, I've always wanted to go on a tour with Dibs, and because I've always been, I feel like I'm the same vibe, like, and Doug, what he did, so to be able to combine our shows, like, that's the difference to me. Like, I got that personal time, like, with Dibs, to be able to, like, really see how he, like, prepares for his shows and sets up. I learned a lot, you know, and I also think that there were people who were, like, handling the money instead of me doing it or handling the dates, because I pretty much, like, manage glue, you know, so it's like somebody else was doing the things that I usually do. It was a nice break, and I got to worry about performing and just holding them down every night. So it was nice. It was great, and I really, really enjoyed the people who I was rolling with, and I got to know them a lot better, you know, and so like a family when you're on tour. And I felt very disconnected from that, because I felt like we've either been rolling solo or on a tour as big as the Warped Tour, where like you don't really connect with people like on that level if you're driving your own car, except for a couple people, you know? So, and that's the other biggest big tour that I've been on besides this.
Six on a 1 to 10. Maybe a 7, because I thought it was going to be a lot worse than it was. I had a lot more fun than I thought I would.
Great shit to do this summer. We went to a lot of markets that, you know, I would have probably had to wait, that I couldn't sneak in the spring. So I think it's good. I think it's going to be something that has to develop, kind of like this group developed. I think if people decide, if the powers that be decide to do another script tour, that I think you'll see that it's kind of a process just like any tour is, even though, you know, that script built up. Third, fifth, sixth year, the word of mouth started spreading. I think you start seeing.
RV. I ain't never fucked with an RV before, man. Bed situation is cool, except you get motion sickness if you fuck with that shit too much. I mean, I think for something short like this, it's tight. But I think, I don't know if I could do this for 8 to 10 weeks. And this, I think, I mean, this thing looks like fucking, you got a fight in it already. This thing will be fucking on fire in another 2.5 weeks. Yeah, it looks shitty. Yeah, pan over there. Look at that. Pan on that. Look at all that shit.
Pan to the floor. Look how brown the floor is. The groove loves titties. It's probably the greatest saying of all time. Watching Mr. Dibs pour a whole bottle of water into a monitor in Denver, Colorado. That was amazing. Just like channeling all of like every member of Motorhead in his body and destroying the backstage in Denver. That was nice. Counting merch at the end of the night. Zing out, bitch.
The best moment for me was the Philly show and how well attended it was. And it was good because right before the Philly show, RJ picked me up. We were around the corner at this park, just eating and chilling. He's like, look, you know, told about this other tour that was there a week before us, you know, on there like a Tuesday night as well. He said he stopped up to see it, and he was like, oh man, he's like, they'd be lucky if they had 30 or 50 people in there. He's like, so don't get disappointed, you know, if people don't come out. He's like, I don't know what's up. And he walked back at like 8:45, and it was thick in there. And then the crowd was live, because Philly crowds are not live, ever.
I've been on worse. I could do it again. I would change the fucking 35-hour ride home. Miami.
Yo, Nito, you blew like fucking frostbite. Oh! Yo, Nito, you on a fucking turntable. Well, I'm on tour. Oh! Yo, Nito, you're fucking intense like a nympho in a campground. Oh! No, that one was really good.
Yeah, like there's some cities, but in general, like other than the ride home, is probably the worst part of the tour.
Yeah, man. Tell me when we got hotels ahead of time so I can know what I need to be doing.
My underwear a little more often. I would fucking beat Pace's ass for shitting in the fucking RV. I would have jumped over and wrestled an alligator when we were in Florida. I would have not played Miami. I would have, I don't know what I would have changed. I don't think I would have changed much. I had a great time.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'd go on another one.
I would definitely go on another Scribble tour. If the price is right, motherfucker.
You know what? Horseshit! Yeah. I have gills.
What
I'm not used to your oxygen.
Just when you thought it was safe, the mass shall passe, hit you up with another case. Just when you thought it was safe, the mass shall passe, hit you up with another case.
Yeah, 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 ye
quick for bastards to step to. Leave wounds too drastic for rescue. When I rock jewels, it ain't to impress you. What the fuck am I expecting on my shit for?
Scribble, 10 I'm years cool, in this cool. bitch.
We but here's the P and Scribble and Fat Nick, man. And,
oh, yeah. Jesus, what a fucking retarded.
Bitch. First tour.
We're broke.
LA didn't pay up.
LA didn't pay up, right? Like, we didn't get paid quite appropriately for LA, so it's pigeon rolls tonight. And, I think we get about two or three of these birds. You know what I'm saying? Why have this shit? We just fucking eat. Get her done. Woo!
There you go. Get it. Oh! 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 Early, man.